Before we get into an investigation of how the bandwidth choice affects our kernel density estimate, let's form some kernel density estimator using our IPython notebook and some Python code. Look at the block of code here. We're going to use the stats module from SciPy. Here we are defining a function that chooses various bandwidth factors. This part of the code defines a function that gives us a kernel density estimate from our data. Let's run both these pieces of code. As they were both simply functions, they didn't give us any results yet. But let's now call the function and plot them with a bandwidth factor of 0.1. Let's see what happens. Run this piece of code. Upon running the code, you will get a plot that looks something like this. It might have taken you a while to run, depending on the computer you're using. So have patience and let it finish. Here, the bandwidth is very, very small, and we see a density estimate that is quite jaggedy. We are now going to increase the bandwidth factor by 2. Let's see what happens. Again, once it finishes running, you will see a kernel density estimate. The green line is still a little bit jaggedy, but smoother than the last one. Let's keep doing this. For each of the next 3 lines of code, we have changed the bandwidth factor to 0.7, 0.9, and 0.99. Run all 3. For a factor of 0.7, you see a more smooth density estimate. Here is the density obtained for the factor of 0.09. Here's the density estimate with the largest bandwidth selected. Now we have a much smoother kernel density estimate. So you see, as we vary h from a small value to a large value, the variations in the kernel density estimate itself become smaller and the smoothness of the curve increases. The jaggediness or the variation is in fact called the variance. The smoothness is part of what is called the bias. We can trade off between variance and bias by choosing a higher or lower bandwidth. We will now investigate if there is a way to find an optimal bandwidth.